Or did a poor Wylan? Oh, we're live. I was
live?
Like,
Okay.
yeah. But yeah, I think it'll be really good. I don't know, super fun.
Yeah.
You don't see it every day. You don't see painted fabric every day.
No, and painted fabric that feels nice. Feels nice. So, all right. Welcome, welcome. Thanks for tuning in today. We are going to be working on painting fabric with Annie Sloan Paint, and I'm going to also show you how to dye some fabric with Annie Sloan Paint. So I'm going to start out with some of our dyeing. I've got a couple of cups of warm water here, and this week's video will be a little shorter. I'm sorry, I talked a lot last week. Had a lot to say. We'll make this one a little bit more reasonable so you can stay tuned in. I am going to be using Florence. I'm just going to pour a little bit of paint in each of these containers and give them a good stir so that that paint is really mixed out. I'm using a fork because the holes in the tines like that will actually help the paint mix up really nice. That stirred together, get that mixed in really, really nice. I'm working in a really small cup, so if I have a little bit of paint that settles to the bottom, I may get a little darker area, and it can turn out a little bit tie-dyed, a little bit uneven sometimes because of that. So the more it is stirred in, the more even your dyeing process is going to be. So Annie will use a large metal tub, or you can use your bathtub if you've got a laundry sink. That works really, really well. And a good stir here. So when you're working with fabrics, your natural fiber fabrics are definitely going to work the best. So something that is cotton, linen, silk, those types of fabrics are going to work best. Rope, jute, anything that is all natural is going to be much more absorbent and it's going to take your dye. If you have something that's 100% polyester, you're not going to see the same kind of results. So I am going to take a little piece of printed fabric here and I'm going to put it down in my cup. Clearly my dark color here isn't going to take a lot of dye because I already have a lot of color in that thread, but my lighter areas are going to take up the tint in the paint, and the backside will. So I'm just going to kind of smush that down in there. And give it a little stir. And the other thing I'm going to color is one of our Better Than Cheesecloth towels. So these are 100% cotton, and we've actually had a handful of customers come in and buy these to use as guest towels or napkins. And we've had customers dye these with our paint. We've had customers come in and embellish them by purchasing some lace or other types of notions and sew them around the edges and create a really nice look with that. You can stencil on top of this and make designs that way. So really a very fun and affordable way to customize that. Push that down in there. That up. I'm going to leave these soak for a little bit as I'm working. Set those off to the side. And then we have fancy tools this week. All right, and I am going to be working on this. I made a mock cushion, and please ignore my funky little sides here. I got some remnant foam and stapled it onto a board here to mock up a chair cushion. And what you're doing with this is you're basically kind of dyeing this fabric in place. So you don't want to put it on too thick and heavy because each of the fibers in the fabric itself, if you get the paint on too heavy, as you move the fabric around, that paint will kind of break apart in between the different threads. So you really just want to start with a cup of water, basic just water. All I have is water, and I'm going to paint my surface with water. That's it. I want to get it wet. Some people will use a spray bottle for this step, but I find that a brush works better because you really need to push the water down into the fabric. You don't want the water just sitting on top, okay? If the water just sits on top, as you know, as I put it on here, and it's not soaked in, I'm not going to get my paint to soak in like I need it to. So I don't need to saturate my fabric. I don't really need to soak it. I just want to get it wet. I'm trying to work with the fabric that's on there, which obviously fabric is not super thick. I mean, I've got this thin amount of fabric here. That's it. I don't need to saturate through all of that foam or batting or whatever else is under there, just the fabric itself. So I'm going to continue across my surface and get that nice and damp. Around there. That feels good. Oh, I knew we forgot something. I forgot my old ochre paint.
Old ochre or country gray?
I used old ochre. Yes. See, I knew there would be something we forgot. We were going through our list and saying, oh, I think we have everything this week. We remembered a can opener and everything, and then here I go. I forgot the very color paint I was using on here. Too funny. So I'm gonna wet this side here. Just a sample pot's good, Neil. The sample pot, yeah, perfect.
It was buried under all of that.
All right, good, good, good. Thank y'all. So I'm just going to continue around here and get this wet. So definitely painting fabric requires a little more patience than working with wood, because I'm going to need to build up my color a little more slowly for the best results. And you're going to need to let those coats dry in between. And we're using a lot of water, so that dry time is going to be significantly more than what it would be over wood. So your typical dry time over wood is, or another painted surface, a solid surface like that, is, you know, 10-15 minutes. And over this, it's going to be hours. So you may even have to wait overnight to put another coat on, depending on how much water you used and your room temperature. I'll get that covered. All right, there we go. Now you can see our surface is nice and damp. And I am going to go into okay, I'm going to dip into my paint with the same brush that I was using and go across my surface. And you can see it's really flowing very nicely over the top. It really glides very, very far over that damp surface with my damp brush. And I'm just getting a nice thin coat across there. Bit more paint, and if I feel like it's starting to grab a little bit, I can dip back into my water and help that spread out. So nice thin coat. We don't want to get really thick areas on here because that's just going to clog up the threads, and you want this to stay really nice and soft. So now I'm going to go back over it a little bit more. And you can see we're working over a very dark fabric. This is a very dark fabric, and I am painting it a very light color. So I'm not going to get the same kind of coverage that I would, of course, with a darker color, nor am I getting the same kind of coverage that I would over a piece of wood, because I'm using my paint much more thinly and I'm working over a dark surface. So we have two things kind of working against us. So really just spreading that out. Edges a little bit. So if I feel like it's a little bit thick, just dip into my water a little bit more and really help spread that out. I really want it to be more like I'm dyeing the fabric. If I put the paint on straight up out of there, it's going to be a little crunchier and stiffer. And I may end up getting a few little cracks in my paint, not because the paint itself really is cracking, but because all of the threads, all the little fibers that make up the fabric can't hold the paint in between them as they move. Cover that. So has anyone on here ever tried painting fabric before? I'd love to know if you have a project that you're thinking about painting, or if you've attempted it before and you're just coming in to learn a little bit more about maybe a better way of doing it than you had done. I'd love to hear from you. And give us some thumbs up and some likes and some hearts and feed us your questions. We're happy to answer them here while we're live, or if you watch it on a replay later. I'm still happy to answer your questions. See, it doesn't take a terribly long amount of time to do it. It's just getting all the way around and making sure that you have some coverage in here.
Getting lots of hearts.
Good. Up. It's so fun. So a lot of the questions that we get about painting fabric is, one, is it going to be crunchy? Well, it depends on how you apply it, first of all. So the thinner that you put it on, the more water you use, the more thin, watery layers you do, the softer your fabric is going to be. So if you're a little bit more patient, your project is going to turn out and feel a lot nicer in the end. If you get impatient and you start putting it on heavy, it's not going to be quite so soft. So, patience, patience, patience. The second thing is, how does the fabric last? Is it going to come off on my clothes? No, it is not going to come off on your clothes. Absolutely not. It is going to dry and it is going to stay there. It's not going to come off on your clothes. No worries about that whatsoever.
We got a question, would you ever use a spray bottle to wet the fabric?
You know, you can use a spray bottle, but I prefer using the cup of water, because when you use a spray bottle and spritz on there, the water tends to just sit on the surface and not soak in as nicely. The other issue that I have come across is when you are working with the paint like this and you need to add a little bit more water, when you spritz it, sometimes it can leave little water specks on it. And you can see those little water specks as it dries, especially in the darker colors. So I like having a little bit more control by just putting a little tiny, tiny bit of water on my brush. The spray bottle is probably going to put more water, and you'll need to do more coats doing it that way too. So that's a good question. I do see a lot of people recommend the spray bottle, and it's perfectly fine. I just prefer this method. I find I have more control doing it this way. So you can see I'm putting a little bit of a second coat on this as it started to dry a little bit, because this fabric is so dark, I need to build up a few more layers, and I can kind of push the boundaries a little bit on that first coat. So I'm gonna need to let this dry now. Going to set it over here. I do that and take out my dry one that I did yesterday. So this has a coat of paint on like we just did that has dried. And you can hear that? It's got a little more stiffness to it. So it is starting to feel like canvas. So instead of it being quite as soft as the fabric started out with, it certainly isn't crunchy, but it is much more stiff and it feels more like canvas. And you can hear it even has more of that canvas kind of sound to it.
Hope we got another question came in.
Sure.
How wet should you get the fabric when it is already on a chair?
So you really just want to try to put enough water to get the fabric itself wet. You don't need to soak it all the way through to the foam or the batting that's underneath there, just the fabric. So I want it to feel, you know, fairly damp, but not saturated. So that's where I like the brush, because I can control how that spreads out a lot more than I can, again, with the spray bottle. Sometimes you can get it a little more wet than you need to. And it's not gonna hurt the fabric to get it wet. It's fabric, it's fine. So you can see I've got a little tiny bit of paint on my brush, but more than anything, I'm just getting my surface damp again with the water and putting that coat of water over the entire surface and getting that nice and damp again. Putting that on here. So the other question that we get a lot about fabric too is it going to stain? Well, of course it will. Your fabric now stains, right? If I spilled grape juice on the fabric that you have on your chairs right now, it's going to stain. Of course it is. So if I paint it, it's not going to stop it from staining. That's going to happen just the same. But there are things that you can do to make it a little bit more resistant to spills and stains and things. And that is, you can use Scotch Guard on it. You can spray Scotch Guard right over it. Just like you can do your fabric now, you can Scotch Guard your painted fabric and it works great. The other thing you can do is put on some clear wax. Now, I would definitely recommend you stick with the clear wax. The clear wax dries much harder than any of the colored wax. It's gonna soak into there and you don't need to worry about that coming off on your clothing. However, if you use a colored wax, there's a lot of tint in there that ends up staying on the surface that doesn't soak in. And so if you get warm and you wiggle around on that brown wax chair and you're wearing white pants, it could be a little embarrassing. So I would definitely stick with the clear wax or just the fabric paint itself, okay? Just paint or just clear wax. And that will not rub off on your clothes. You will not have an embarrassing moment and it is going to last. So you are good, okay? Now, I'll finish getting this wet here. And I'm gonna put my second coat on. All right, so now this is nice and damp. I'm not seeing any puddles or anything as I'm pushing on it, but it does feel nice and damp. And go back into my paint with my brush, the same brush, and I can get a lot more coverage on this next coat here. So I am just going to cover my surface. And again, I'm just letting the brush tell me whether or not it needs more water. If I'm able to really push my paint out, you can see I'm going back into where I started and I'm dragging that paint back out and I'm trying to stretch it out as far as it will go. As long as I can do that, I really don't need to add more water. I just want it to stay nice and thin. So once I'm not able to really move the paint a lot further, and I'm just not progressing, then I'm gonna dip back into my water just a little bit and a little bit more paint. I wanna keep my brush nice and wet and help spread it out to finish that next coat. There we go. With some different brushes doing fabric. The Annie Sloan paintbrush that we typically use, the natural bristle brush, I feel like deposits a little bit more paint and water than you really need on the fabric. You really want to keep it very light, and it doesn't spread out as far as it would on like a wood surface. So you can use one of the more inexpensive natural bristle brushes, but because you're getting it so wet, it gets very floppy very quickly. So you'll need to use quite a few more brushes with that. So I'm using the Annie Sloan smoothing brush, and this works really, really nicely. I don't have to worry about any bristle loss. It really helps push the paint along the surface because it mimics that split end of the natural bristle brush there in the end. So it really does help spread the paint out nice, but I don't have to worry about it getting heavy because I'm using so much water with it.
Question about the wax. Does applying clear wax on fabric give it a more leathery feel?
Or? It will, yes. So when we get to our last coat here, I'll kind of show you the difference on that. And it really comes down to personal preference. So when you are painting your fabric, said it's going to get a little bit more of a canvas type of feel to it. It's going to be more like a duck fabric, if you're familiar with what a canvas duck is. And that is something that is, you know, a little thicker feeling than maybe a, you know, regular type of woven fabric would be. It's a little heavier, a little thicker than that. And if you put the wax on it, it definitely gives it more of a leathery feel to it. It's also going to add a little bit of a sheen to it, which adds to the look of it. You know, looking more like a leathery type of look. And that can be really, really nice as well. And it does stay really soft putting that on. Said it gives it a little bit of a sheen, and then it does give it a little bit of protection too. So if you, you know, spilled a glass of water or something on the fabric, it wouldn't soak in right away. You'd have just, you know, a few minutes or seconds to soak that up and get it cleaned up so that it's not getting all over your fabric. So like, you know, a juice spill or something like that is gonna be a little bit more resistant. I mean, nothing is perfect, it's still absorbent, but it gives you, you know, a little bit of time to clean it up. So just working around my fabric like that, I'm gonna get that other coat on there and I'm gonna let this dry now. So that's two coats of the Old Ochre over this very dark, heavy patterned fabric. I'll put that off to the side. And then, voila, this is three coats. So can you tell on film, Neil, that I can still see a little bit of pattern through there, or does it look fairly opaque?
And there's I think there's a little coming through. It's kind of hard to... It looks pretty solid. Every once in a while I can see the pattern, but yeah. I think it's because I know it's there.
So it is, I think that if I were doing this myself, I would put another coat on. Again, it's a very light colored paint over a very dark colored fabric. If I were using, say, graphite or Napoleonic blue or the Florence that we're using to dye today, I would definitely have full coverage at this point. Absolutely, it would be covered because those have a lot more pigment in the paint themselves, and the value of that color is going to be more closely aligned with the value of the darker portion of this print. So I wouldn't have to worry about that. But because I'm going light, when I looked at it this morning, I thought, oh, I probably would put another coat on. But I'm going to hold off because I want to show you the final step of what you can do. So if you, can you zoom in a little bit, Neil, and kind of look at this? I want everyone to kind of see the fabric itself as I'm pushing on it. You can see that it's not cracking or anything on there. It's soft, but you have a stiffness to it. It feels like a stiff canvas. And so I want to soften that up a little bit, and I'm gonna use a little bit of sandpaper to do that. You wanna use a finer grit sandpaper. So if you have any sanding sponges, the fine would be the way to go. I'm using 320 grit sandpaper here today. I wouldn't go any coarser than a 220. And I'm just going to lightly sand over my surface. really just gonna soften up that texture. Gonna break off that kind of stiff feeling that's on there. See, I'm not spending a lot of time on it. This section here, I put my paint on a little bit thicker, and you can see a lot more is coming off now because I allowed my paint to dry more thickly. I used this little section with less water so that we could see the difference on there. I'm gonna need to sand that a little bit more, then I do my top. Really soft. It feels like fabric again. It doesn't feel like that stiff canvas. It feels like my fabric is thicker now than it was before. It feels heavier. It feels more like a heavy-duty upholstery fabric rather than a thinner fabric that may be used for clothing, which this was not a really heavy upholstery fabric. It was a very lightweight upholstery fabric, so now it feels like a heavyweight one. And you can see as I push on it, it stays really soft. I'm not getting any cracks or movement in there. It feels really, really nice. Really, really nice. I'm gonna do a little section with some wax so you can kind of see what the difference is on that. So the side here feels really good. Got my wax on. So immediately you can see that color is starting to darken, right? Because the wax is soaking into there and deepening the color just a little bit. Of course, I wipe off my excess. And rub that. You see a little bit of a shine to it at all on the camera? It's very subtle, it's very soft. But it feels even smoother now than the front of the fabric. It has much more softness to it. It really now very closely resembles how it felt when I first started. Really nice and soft. It has a lot of give to it. It has that little bit of protection to it now, and it feels very, very nice. Very nice. So what do you think? Good, good, good? All right. Now I'm going to show you this fabric that we've been coloring. Oh, squeeze this out here. So this has our Florence paint on it. And you can see how it has colored the fabric. It's a little bit uneven, partly because of my cup and because I've folded it in my cup to do that. If you're working in a larger surface, it's gonna do that a little bit less. And this, as I dry it, can lighten a little bit. So this is, if I like it the way it is, I would definitely let it air dry and then put it in a hot dryer or even iron it. And that's going to heat press the color into it and going to retain the color much stronger than if I would rinse it and wash it right away. So that heat definitely holds the paint in stronger. So that's that one. Our better than cheesecloth here. Oh, it's a little messy. multicolor here. Isn't that pretty? Love the way that color turned out. So when you look at the paint color itself in the pot, you can see that it's definitely going to dye much lighter than what the color is, but that the color is definitely in the same family. It's just a lighter version of it. And that's because we're adding that water to it and you are dyeing rather than painting. So I'll show you a couple of samples that I did yesterday with this. And remember, this is how it started. So very light, just an off-white color. I use Lem Lem, which is going to be a really light color here. So compared to the original, again, let me pull that off. Here's the original here. Can you see that okay, Neo? And then here's with the Lem Lem. So the Lem Lem's a really light color, so it's not going to change it near as significantly as the darker color like Florence. And on the back, again, you can see the little bit of green on there. And then this is what the Better Than Cheesecloth looks like. So a really light, light color. Then I used Giverny, which got a stronger blue here. Again, you've got a lot of blue on the back. And the blue on our Better Than Cheesecloth. And then I did burgundy, which I love the way the burgundy turned out. I think that's super pretty. You can see the coloring on the back, much stronger. And the Better Than Cheesecloth. And these I rinsed immediately. All three of the ones I did yesterday, I did not heat set at all. I rinsed them out in warm water in my sink immediately after dyeing them. So they're all gonna be a little bit lighter than what it would be if I would have heat set them first. So I think that turned out really nice. And these then, once that's done, you can wash and dry your fabric, absolutely, and use that. So it's fun to be able to have lots of different options with your paint colors. I'd love to know what you think of our episode today, our dyeing and painting fabric with Annie Sloan Paint. Chalk paint works great for this because Annie's paint, of course, doesn't have those plastic resins in, and that's why it stays really flexible and soft. And that's really what sets us apart from the other paints on the market. You don't have to add any kind of medium to it or anything, just the paint itself is going to stay flexible. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you guys next week.